Okay, let's stop horsing around for a moment, shall we? We're here to talk about the Western, a film genre depicting westward expansion between 1865 and 1890, beginning in 1903 with the silent film The Great Train Robbery, which is considered to be the first Western. A genre is noted by Thomas Schatz as something that involves familiar, essentially one-dimensional characters acting out a predictable story pattern within a familiar setting. Each genre in film has a specific iconography, which is defined by Barry Keith Grant. He states that iconography refers to particular objects, archetypal characters, and even specific actors. The iconography present in the Western genre includes specific trademarks you wouldn't find in any other film. For example, the gunfight at high noon, the landscape of Monument Valley, the sound of horses or a cracking whip, a tumbleweed or a villainous gunman dressed in all black. These icons are all particular to the typical Hollywood Western, which describes films such as High Noon, Shane, and The Searchers. The Spaghetti Western, however, has its own specific iconography. Now, let's take a look at A Fistful of Dollars, the 1964 film by Sergio Leone. We begin with our protagonist, the man with no name, who is portrayed by none other than Western icon Clint Eastwood. If you don't think of Westerns when you hear his name, then you've definitely been living under a rock. Now, the man with no name enters a town on the edge of the Mexican border and decides that he is going to stay to earn some money. The character is very intelligent and pits two rival families, the Rojo brothers and the Baxters, against each other. The character is an anti-hero of sorts, as he isn't killing people for the betterment of the community, but for his own monetary gain. He's not without altruistic motivations, however, as he ends up helping rescue a woman from the Rojo brothers so that she may escape with her son. When asked why, he replies with this.
Here you are. Now take this money. It's enough to live on for a while. Now get across the border. Much distance between yourselves and San Miguel as possible.
How may we thank you for what you are doing?
Don't try. Just get going before the Rojos get here.
Why do you do this for us?
Why? I knew someone like you once. There was no one there to help. Now get moving.
We never truly understand the character's motivations, but we are rooting for him, despite his wrongdoings. Another icon of the spaghetti western are the overly violent action sequences. There is murder just for the sake of it, with vibrant blood and exaggerated deaths. Characters in spaghetti westerns also wear worn and dirty clothing that seem to have been actually used and not just freshly laundered and pressed. They feel lived in and they make the characters seem more realistic. Death is taken more lightly in this film and the spaghetti western in general, as you can see in this scene. Death isn't a justified thing, it's just an excuse for the characters to get what they want. The iconography in this film isn't specific to visuals, however, the soundtrack is just as memorable. The score of this film, written by Ennio Morricone, takes the viewer through the ups and downs of the film and remains in your head like a spaghetti western parasite, and you find yourself whistling it for days afterwards. It makes you think of not only the film, but of the Western genre itself. Throughout the film, you can hear other icons such as the cracking of a whip, the sound of horse hooves, or even the sound of spurs as a character walks. Whenever you hear these sounds, you are brought back to the Western visual. So whether it be audio or visual, A Fistful of Dollars is an excellent example of how a film reflects the themes and features of a spaghetti Western. It has been the inspiration for many other films and allowed the genre to grow with the times. So to Sergio Leone, I thank you.